Welcome to video lecture series in Sociology. Today we will start discussing chapter 7 titled as Mass Media and Communications from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. We will divide this chapter broadly into four parts. The first part deals with understanding mass media, that is the basic concept of mass media. We will discuss various types and features of mass media in this part. In the second part, we will discuss about the emergence of mass media. Here, we will also discuss about the functions and impact of mass media on society. In the third part of this chapter, we will discuss about the emergence of mass media after independence. And in the fourth part, we will discuss about the nature and content of mass media in the era of globalization. That is how mass media has changed in the last two decades. Let us begin by understanding the basic concept of mass media. You might have come across this concept many a times in your life. But what is mass media? We can elaborate the concept by breaking it down into two parts. The first part is mass, which means many or many people. And media is the plural for word medium. A medium is a channel of communication. It is a means through which we can send and receive something like information. A book or a newspaper is a medium. They communicate something to us when we read them. A medium is a link or a channel of communication through which people exchange information. Mass media is a means of public communication reaching to a large number of people or audience at the same time. So we can simply define mass media as mass communication or public communication transmitted electronically or mechanically to a large number of people or audience at the same time. These means of communication are also called as channel of communication, which involves a message, a communicator, a channel, a receiver, and an effect. Here we, that is WE, includes you and me at two different ends using a means of mass media to communicate, like this lecture series uses a medium to communicate sociology subject to a wide number of students all over India. Mass media can be broadly divided into two categories. The first is the electronic media, which includes television, radio, films, movies that transmit information which is already recorded or live in nature electronically. The print media uses tangible entities to disseminate information, which includes newspaper, magazines, books, brochures, newsletters, leaflets, posters, and pamphlets. But this communication, you'll be wondering, is one way. Media, both print and electronic, are unidirectional in nature, which means that some information is communicated to us and the audience is a mere recipient of this information. They cannot take part in the communication like a dialogue or discussion. That is why mass media is differentiated from personal interactions, where both the parties are involved in interaction and can equally participate. Brian Dutton and others argue that the mass media can be differentiated from other forms of communication on the basis of four essential characteristics. These characteristics or differences are number one, distance, two, technology, number three, scale, and number four, commodity. Let us discuss these characteristics or differences one by one in detail. Let us begin with distance. In mass media, the sender or recipient of information cannot communicate. There is a gap between the two. The distance can exist both in terms of time and space or both time and space. This form of communication is not direct. It's impersonal. It lacks immediacy and is one way or unidirectional. For example, when you watch a movie or any TV program, no matter how much you relate to the program emotionally in terms of liking or disliking it, but you cannot change or influence the direction of the story as per your liking or disliking. The second important characteristic is technology. Mass media or communication essentially involves means of technology to transfer this information and also to receive this information, like a television or a radio set, or some means to print newspaper or book. Technology, in fact, helps in sending and receiving information at both the ends. The third important characteristic of mass media, according to Brian Dutton, is scale. As the first part of the name mass media suggests, that is mass, mass media involves dissemination of information or communication with large number of people simultaneously. Example, millions of people watch live telecast of games and other sporting events world over at the same time. They might be located at different places, but they can watch the event at the same time. And finally, Dutton talks about fourth characteristic, that is commodity. An interesting feature of mass communication is that one has to pay a price to consume or enjoy this commodity. As this transmission involves some means of technology to transfer and receive information, like a gadget, a TV or a radio set. The consumers have to pay price for this information, which is sold as a commodity. We have to buy newspapers or magazines, radio, or we have to buy a TV set to watch programs, and we now also have to pay for subscribing channels from cable operators to watch these programs. So far, we have discussed about mass media as involving one-way communication or unidirectional dissemination of information. That is, the receiver of the information is located at a distance and there is no dialogue involved in the communication. However, in the last couple of decades, advancement of technology and innovation has led to development of new forms of communication. These are computer networks and mobile telephony. Now, what is different in these new forms of communication? The new forms of communication involve one-to-one communication or interpersonal communication. Unlike the traditional mass media or means of communication, that was communication with many at the same time or one-way communication, the new means of communication involve both the sender and the recipient of information at the same time or at the same space, which makes it interpersonal communication. The best example is mobile phone or video conferencing facilities in computer chatting rooms and other types of social media. Another interesting feature is that this technology is not only interpersonal, but medium can connect many to many people at the same time, where everyone can communicate to everyone in the network. All the participants in this kind of communication are senders and recipients of the information at the same time. For example, teleconferencing or internet chat rooms. Sending a message to many at the same time happens in these cases. Interestingly, the notion of distance does not apply in this form of mass communication. An important example of means of new mass communication is the social network media like Facebook, Twitter, and blogs. With these mediums, a person can communicate in varying combination, such as one-to-one. Such kind of communication happens among close friends when you talk to a friend, one-to-one. The second is one-to-many. This is among a group of friends or many people. One friend can talk to many people at the same time. The third way is to communicate is many-to-one. For example, when a celebrity is replying or chatting with many people at the same time. And the last, a large number of people can communicate with a large number of people, that is many to many. Like on a blog or on Facebook, when you become part of a large virtual community, sending and receiving information at the same time. So you are a producer of the information as well as the consumer of the information. According to Crosby, the new media has a distinct set of characteristics. These are number one, technology, number two, collective control, and number three, personalization. By technology, we mean the new media runs on a complex web of technology, that is computer systems and virtual connectivity. Under point number two, that is collective control, each person involved in the communication here is a potential producer and consumer of the information being exchanged. Everyone can share, create, or modify the content of messages and the information that is being exchanged over the networks. And finally, personalization. Information shared here has a personal character. One can send and receive personalized or individualized messages to each other. For example, wishing each other a new year or a festival or any anniversary. These messages can be delivered to a large number of people simultaneously. You can also send a special e-card wishing people Rakhi or birthdays. One can also send documents or photographs or even video clips as attachments to others. Another important aspect related to mass media and communication is about the differences between the use and access to mass media and means of communication by different sections of people in society. This phenomena is called as digital divide. Digital divide can be defined as or seen as a difference, discrepancy or gap between people who have and those who do not have the resources and access to modern means of communication and technology. It means those who use or those who do not use these means to remain connected with people all over the world. The concept of digital divide also indicates the gap between those who have and those who do not have the necessary skills, knowledge and abilities to use these means of communication and technologies. The digital divide can be noticed between people belonging to different income groups such as rich and poor, the educated and uneducated people, or people belonging to or living in urban and rural areas where you have connectivity or you do not have connectivity. At global level, this divide can be seen between nations in developing and the developed world. It is difficult to imagine a time when there was no television, no cinema, no newspaper, telephones, internet or mobiles. To know the importance of presence of these means of mass communication in your life, imagine a day that you have to spend without these means of communication to remain connected with the world. Telephones, particularly mobile phones and lately internet, has revolutionized the field of communication. Not just the urban centers, even in the rural and far-flung or remote areas, people use the facility of telephones to remain in touch with their family and friends. Businessmen carry a lot of business over phones, such as ordering the items or checking about various things such as delivery. The entire BPO industry, that is call centers, are based on internet and telephone services that connect people to others thousands of miles away. It can be noticed that there has been a phenomenal expansion of types of means of communication in the recent years. You will be surprised to know that India has the second largest communication network. By communication network, we mean the number of telephone users. India is also world's third largest internet user base with over 137 million users as per the statistics of June 2012. India is one of the fastest growing cell phone markets as well. The industry has grown over 20 times in the last 10 years. The massive expansion of mass media has resulted in changing the nature and structure of social, economic and cultural institutions in modern India. Why? Because there is a dynamic relationship between mass media and society. As a student of sociology, it is worth understanding that how mass media is shaping nature of social relationships and social behavior. As there is a dialectical relationship between mass media and society, both influence one another. It would be interesting for you to explore various examples where you see that how aspects of mass media influence your everyday life and social behavior. The structure and content of mass media, like any other social institution, is shaped by changes in the economic, political, and social cultural context of a given society. At the same time, mass media has a huge capacity to shape the nature of society itself. It influences people's lives, their perceptions, and their values. This relationship can be seen in the context of Indian society very well. Initially, after independence, media and its content was shaped by the vision of the state regarding the development and the nation building. However, in the last two decades, since 1990s, market forces have dominated the field of mass media. Market has become the key player in determining the nature and content of mass media. You can see a dialectical relationship between media and society in these cases. Both influence one another. What is the nature of this influence is highly debated. Is it a positive influence or negative? The debate goes on. We'll discuss more about this dialectical relationship in the subsequent sections of this chapter. But unlike other means of communication like telephone, internet, etc., mass media requires a formal structure and organization as it involves huge investment, large capital for production and distribution of media programs. This form of media functions as an industry employing a large number of people. To conclude this session, let's summarize what we discussed in this lecture. We began our discussion by understanding the concept of mass media and its features. We discussed about the features of mass media as given by Brian Dutton. We also discussed about the difference between the traditional and new forms of mass media and communication, and we discussed about the features of both these types. We also touched upon the concept of digital divide and what is the difference between those who use and those who do not use the modern means of communication. In the next part of this chapter, we'll discuss about the functions of mass media. Till then, you can enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.